Hey everybody, this is Nick, and I'm coming to you with a viewer question from Lauren, and she asked about our zip code lookup template and our zip code lookup lessons here on YouTube, where I show you how to take a list of zip codes and turn them into, or search, or look up things like city, county, state from those zip codes and use pivot tables to summarize them. Her question was not about Excel, but wondering if we could do the same thing in Google Sheets. And so you can, Lauren, and we'll see if this helps your question, but we'll see how we can do this here. So right now on the screen, I do have a Google Sheet, and I just have copied the zip code database into a Google Sheet. So you wanna do that. And I was having a hard time copying and pasting all of the data with Control C and Control V. So what I ended up doing is going to the File tab. If you had a blank, let's just create a blank sheet right here. This is a blank sheet in Google Sheets. Just go to File and then Import right here on that file. And from there, you can import data from an Excel spreadsheet. So I'm going to go over here and to click on the Upload tab and then Browse, and then you'll be able to find where that data lives. So this was my zip code lookup database right here. I had that in a separate Excel file, so you want to make sure that that's how you have it over there on your end too. And then it's going to give me this prompt. I'm going to say import data. It's just going to take a little while of time, and then you'll get a link that says open now. And when you do that, all of the data imports from Excel into Google Sheets. So here's open now, and I'm going to do that, and it gives me this sheet right here. Now here's our zip code lookup template, or zip code lookup data, the database. I'm gonna go ahead and create a new tab right here. And this might be where you have your zip code. So 49423, let's see what this was. 49423, that's the zip code from where I'm from in Michigan. I live in this zip code right now, 98121. And let's see, 80206, that's where I was from before. Okay, so let's go ahead and just create our columns just like we did before, city, county, state. And over on the Excel tutorial, we could use either the XLOOKUP function or the VLOOKUP function. And here in Google Sheets, we have access to both of those functions. So let's try and use the XLOOKUP. So type equals XLOOKUP, and you can see it gives us this XLOOKUP pop-up. I'm just gonna double click there, and I'm gonna say search for this zip code, comma, and then go over to the zip code lookup database. Click on that whole column, so just click on the letter above to highlight the entire column. And then this is gonna be our city, so I want to pull from this column right here. I'm going to close the parentheses, and we're gonna push enter, and it gave me Holland, Michigan. That's where it's from. We'll do the same thing for county, so equals XLOOKUP. Point to the zip code that we wanna look up, put a comma in, click on the zip code database, and let's go to the county that's in column H. Close the parentheses. And it looks like it didn't quite give me that. Let's see what I did wrong. Oh, I did something wrong here. Okay, let me delete this. I need to say, okay, we're gonna look up this value here, and I want it to pull from column A. Oops, there we go. And then a comma, and then we're gonna return what's in column H. So close that parenthesis, push enter, and there's our county. Same thing for state, lookup, XLOOKUP. Look up that value there. Comma, go back to the database, look up from A, comma, look up from G, that's our state, close that parenthesis, and there we go. Holland, Michigan, Ottawa County, and the state is Michigan. So this is perfect. And then to copy that down the rest of your zip code, just highlight that entire row of cell, or just that range of cells right there, and just drag it down. That will be responsive. And so any of the formula, or the formulas then, will then point to this zip code in the subsequent row. So you have Seattle, King County, Washington, Denver, Denver County. Perfect. And then if you wanted to summarize these in a pivot table, what I would just do is highlight the entire list of zip codes that you have, or you could just do this in a running wing and highlight all of the columns. And then you can insert a pivot table from the insert tab, insert pivot table, and we can do that exactly like we normally would. It's just gonna be from a new sheet. And then in the rows, we're gonna go ahead, or in the values actually, I'm gonna go ahead and add zip code to the value, and we're going to make sure that it just says count instead of sum, because we want to know how many zip codes we have in our list, and we have 3 zip codes in our list. And then in our rows, let's go ahead and add Let's do cities. So we're going to do that, and then you can see that I have now a list of cities, Denver, Holland, and Seattle. And if I had multiple entries, multiple zip codes from the same city, then this number over here would be more than one. It would be however many zip codes we have for that city. So that's how to do it in Google Sheets. It's almost the exact same way that you do it in Excel. You have the same functionality. You just have to make sure to first transfer over that zip code lookup database from the United States Postal Service into a Google Sheet here, and then on a new tab you can put in your zip code list. So I hope this helps, Lauren, and anyone else. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. And this string of zip code lookup videos is very, very popular. So thank you all for watching, and I can't wait to see you all next time.